Assalamu alaikum. Hi my dear students, how are you all? I hope you are doing great and you are safe at home. I hope so. Okay, first lesson, we have completed the first lesson. Okay, whale hunting, but I didn't explain the notes, so I got only a few notebooks for correction. Rest of the students didn't give what happened. So if you have any doubt, you can call me through mobile and ask whatever doubts you having. Okay, so the first lesson, all of you, those who have returned the notebook, please take out your classwork, English classwork, so that when I am saying, you can see whether you have written it correctly or not. Okay, so all of you take out your classwork and have your pencil or pen with you. Okay, so the first lesson is whale hunting, very interesting lesson we have seen. So in notebook, in English notebook, first the topic you have to write, and then first meanings you have to write, and then if you have any, choose the best answer, fill up. Okay, after that you have to continue, and the last one only you have to write the answer, the following. Okay, you have to write in a neat way. Okay, don't scribble, don't tear the page. So you write in a neat way. So first one is meanings. Okay, date is very, very important. Some of the students, you are not putting the date is very, very important, so put the date, write neatly. Okay, so what is the first is meanings. Okay, in your lesson, first meaning is sultry. Sultry means what? Very hot. Okay, that is sultry. Sultry and very hot and humid. Spouting means flowing out with force. So in a sea, if any heavy things or fish are inside it, so it the water will spout. The water will spout. Okay, that is spouting. It will goes ups and down. That is spouting, flowing out with force. Okay, next one. Harpoon, I told you, it is a weapon used for killing the whales. So here in your book, we are not writing the long meanings, and we are cut short and we are writing. Okay, don't want to worry, I'm explain you, so you see that what are the words you are written correct or not. Harpoon, harpoon, harpoon. Okay, a long heavy spear. Okay, it's a long, you know, heavy means weight, fixed to a rope. Okay, when I was taking the class, that time I was drawn and I show you what is an harpoon. So it is a rope used for whale hunting. Second one, stern, the back part of a boat. Okay, stern means the back part of the boat. And then crimson means deep red. Okay, crimson means red color. Okay, so these are the meanings. Next one is choose the best answer in your textbook you are having. What is it? How do you think Ismail could tell if a dolphin, a porpoise or a whale was nearby? So what is the answer? Is answer C. He could see a whale spouting water. That is the answer. Second one, what does a phrase to a man mean in the words asleep or dozing to a man? So here they given A, B, C. C is the correct answer. A dozen men were sleeping. Okay, second one, what does the phrase to a man mean to the words asleep or dozing to a man? A, Everyone was asleep. Everyone was asleep is the correct answer. A is the correct answer. And then sixth, here Mr. Stubbs' face looked red because why Mr. Stubbs' face looked red? Because the sun was reflecting the color of the sea. The sun was reflecting the color of the sea. So B is the correct answer. B is the correct answer. So now we are going to see the question answer. What are the two types of whales? What are the two types of whales? Whales can be classified as either toothed or baleen. Toothed whales have teeth, baleen whales don't. Okay, toothed whales have teeth, baleen whales don't have the teeth. Second one, why was the, so there are two types of whales is there. Whales can be classified as either toothed or baleen whales. Second one, why was the whale's back glistening? Why it was shining? They are asking. The whale's back glistening because it looks like a mirror. So the back part of the whale, it's look like a mirror. So when the sun falls on the back part of the whale, it's glistening, it's shining. That is the meaning. What was the cause of the foam? F-O-A-M, foam. Why the water was floating up and down? The foam was caused because of the whale. Okay, because of the whale, the water was spouting. Okay, up and down. Is there any evidence in the story that the whale was afraid of the sailors? If so, what is it? Okay, so they are asking, is there in the story, is there any evidence that whale was afraid, frightening? Okay, that you have to explain. The whale could sense that he was being followed. Okay, the whale could sense that he was followed by the boatman and moved swiftly. Okay, firstly he was moving away from the boat. So the whale could sense that he was being followed and so moved swiftly away from the boat. So next question, fifth question, describe in about 40 words how the whale was spotted, hunted and killed. Okay, how the boatman was seeing the whale, how they hunted and killed. You have to describe that in 40 words. Ismail, a sailor, spotted a sperm whale. So first Ismail was seeing the saw the sperm whale. Mr. Tubb, second character, wanted to hunt the whale. So not only Ismail, Mr. Tubb also want to hunt the whale. The men on the boat were ready to attack the sea animal. So the men on the boat ready to attack the sea animal. And then what happened? The whale could sense that he was being followed. So the whale could sense that he was followed by the boatmen. So moved swiftly. Firstly, it was moving away from the boat. The men on the boat followed him. They kept attacking. So the boatmen kept attacking the poor sea animal. At last, they killed the animal. At last, what happened? With the help of the harpoon, they killed the sea animal. Mr. Tubb rejoiced as he had killed the whale. So who was very very happy? At last Mr. Stubb was happy after killing the whale. So now I'll read out that, just listen. Ismail, a sailor, spotted a sperm whale. Mr. Stubb wanted to hunt the whale. The men on the boat were ready to attack the sea animal. The whale could sense that he was being followed and so moved swiftly away. The men on the boat followed him. They kept attacking the poor sea animal. At last, they killed the animal. Mr. Tubb rejoiced as he had killed the whale. Okay, so if you have your textbook, take out your textbook. Here, you have a grammar also. Okay, the same in this lesson we have grammar also. Already I sent you the notes and all. In that page number 7, you have one grammar. You have to write separately only. Don't write in classwork notebook. Grammar you have to write separate. You have to put separate notebook for grammar. Okay, don't write in the classwork. That past participle you have to past perfect tense. Okay, past perfect tense you have to write in the grammar notebook. There is exercise page number 7. I already sent you that. Okay, that you have to write in your grammar notebook. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can call me through mobile. Inshallah, we will meet you in next class. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.